The following event occurred in November of 2018.
Hey, bitch.
Hey, what's up?
You're going to Blooms, right?
Yeah, Blooms. Blooms? Final Blooms.
Final Blooms, or one of the final Blooms.
Yeah.
Here, let me adjust the ISO, because it's a little bright in here. So how do you feel about going to the last Blooms?
Fucking strange.
Max Blooms Coffee House in Fullerton hosted one of the longest running open mics in Orange County. In November of 2018, it closed down, effectively ending the open mic.
Yeah. And it's weird because, like I remember, like, telling comics, like, we should, like, appreciate Blooms because it's going to be gone. But I just didn't know it was going to be gone, like, this quick.
Yeah.
Teens on there.
What's up?
What are you guys doing?
We're talking about going to Max Blooms for, like, the last time.
Fuck Max Blooms.
What?
You're going to go to the last one? It's going to be lame, dude.
Fuck you, dude. That's our mic. That's where we started.
So what? I started OC Steelhouse. You don't mean see me trying to like rah, rah, rah.
Yeah, because OC Steelhouse was a fucking piece of shit.
Don't talk that shit.
It's a piece of shit. Where's OC Steelhouse right now? It's a pile of dirt because they fucking tore it down, bitch. It's gone.
Like Kenny said, OC Steelhouse was the first mic he ever went to. It's also the place where he put on his first show. It's also...
Your place is going out of business too, fuckface.
Yeah, but we went out of business last, so fuck you.
Yeah.
I'm not, look, I don't give a fuck about Max Blooms. I'm not going to Max Blooms. You guys shouldn't either. OC Steelhouse for life. OC Steelhouse, bitch.
I think you did it backwards.
OC Steelhouse, bitch.
It looks like you're sucking a big dick.
Don't waste time doing this shit. Like, please edit videos, stick to the fucking schedule. A stupid mic ending should not fuck mixed up.
I'm just gonna Photoshop you sucking a big dick.
And then you're gonna do the zoom in thing, because you only wanna edit one way.
Yeah.
And you're gonna do that.
And then right there,
and
right
then
there.
And you're gonna be like, and then you're gonna put some little fake tits over
right there, over that big old titty.
And I'm gonna put a chipmunk, and I'm gonna edit, because I know how to use Photoshop.
I'm gonna put a name tag that says Vice CEO. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I'm the Vice CEO. People know what's real, dog.
They know. I'm the CEO, bitch.
You're chief editor, dog.
I'm the CEO.
You're CEO of editing. That's it.
Hey, look what I get to do. I get the last word and record.
Yeah, because you're...
Max Blooms was the place where Luis and I first started. In our eyes, it's always been golden. But tonight was the night that we had to face reality and accept the fact that, well... it was gonna go away.
Hey, bitch. All right. Can I get like house coffee?
What were we talking about?
Here's your sweater that you asked for.
Before I left my house, Luis sent me a message asking if I could bring him a sweater. Let me provide some proper context. Luis has no dad. There is a rule. If you're giving Luis a ride home, you are his dad for the night. I was giving Luis a ride home after Max Blooms. I had to fulfill my fatherly duties, so I brought him a sweater. I don't want my little tyke getting pneumonia.
I don't think it fits me. Actually, never mind.
It's the largest one I have.
Oh, well, so what are you trying to say?
You asked for the largest one. You asked for a large sweater.
Thanks for making me look fat. You know?
Fuck you. Anyway. So this is one of the last days of Max Blooms.
Yeah, Blooms. Nothing is ever gonna beat this. Like, it's weird because like I'm feeling the air right now, and I feel like, wow, like this is gonna be one of the last moments. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just like the air, just like music right there. Just people
around. Trippy, huh?
Yeah, Jay's not even gonna be here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is like also kind of like worse, but. I hope he's haunting this place.
I think he is.
Okay.
I think he's gonna haunt this place even after it closes down.
Yeah, that's what I want him to do.
The last dude to host Max Blooms was a fellow by the name of Brandon Jetty. He sadly passed away 3 weeks before the mic folded. It was incredibly sudden and everyone was devastated.
There's not that much comics here, which bothers me.
I'm sure they'll show up.
They better show up.
Taylor's here.
Taylor's here, but he's inside.
He'll come out. So how was it, Taylor?
It's worse than I remembered. That's the Pinnacle Blooms.
Pinnacle Blooms?
Yeah, getting heckled by a homeless. I started like I ended getting heckled by a crazy homeless
person. Yeah!
I got yelled at by somebody who was both drunk and insane. Just, I don't know, I just miss coming in, just seeing Jetty laying back and just not wanting to start the mic for everybody else's sake, but knowing he doesn't want to be there also. It's beautiful.
That's a very beautiful memory. But if you want the quintessential memory, the one that captures Max Bloom's for all of its sad, dingy, shady glory, you gotta go to everyone's favorite fool, David Mendici.
So, it's on a Friday. It's, I think...
Fucking chill.
Yeah, it's...
Comic? Not him. The black one. That sounds racist. He got drunk on his birthday, right?
Yeah.
And then all the Max Bloom's people on a Friday, I don't give a fuck. People can listen. We go, right, and we're outside, and then he's trying to flirt with all these girls, and some random-ass drunk white bitch goes up to him. And before that, she was trying to get, like, Louise was trying to get her digits or whatever, gonna get all, like...
No, dude, I did get her digits, but I didn't hit her up.
If she's drunk, really it don't count. If she's drunk, it don't count.
Yeah, yeah. It's funny, because that's how David Mendes gets most women.
All right. continue.
So... Jetty's outside. He comes outside, he's just watching this. And I don't know where we make that white chick and because they're both blacked out drunk kiss each other and they make out and they're just like, ah! Everyone's just like, it was fucking lit.
What makes this event even more outrageous is that it was actually recorded.
Right. Cue the footage.
Oh dear God. Oh, what is happening? What, why? What, no. Oh, no. Oh God, no.
Like, I don't think I could sleep going home after this. Because like, Jetty's gone, and kind of reminds.
No, you don't.
It's.
Yeah, like, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Like, honestly, like a lot of people are like, you were super close with Jetty. I was like, I kind of was. Not, no, I don't think I was, because like, I know there's more people that like knew him and hanged out with him.
Yeah, you started with him, so.
Yeah, that's the only thing. He was like.
He was like one of your early mentors.
Yeah, at the time I thought.
Sad and endearing.
And it's only been like my year, like I've only been doing this for a year and I already lost someone. That's like fucking, that's what I, not only that, I'm losing like my favorite mic ever.
That's something I wasn't ready for. You just lose like, I mean, again, 3 year in, still a fucking novice, but like in 3 years I've already lost people.
Yeah.
Like, also just the people who quit and you never hear about again.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
Is this like an Asian thing?
Someone, I just found out that Brandon Jetty came inside my wallet.
This is Kyle Gridley, another fellow comedian. He and Brandon were great friends. Not really.
This is before he banned me from Max Bloom's. He came in my wallet and then banned me.
I thought he stole his wallet. That's where I blanked out.
Oh, yeah,
out.
He probably stole $7, a Target gift card with $25 on it, both my debit and credit cards, and then an AutoZone card that had like 5 points on it.
Is that your favorite Max Bloom
memory? Yeah, that's mine. Huh? I know it's mine.
Oh, is that my favorite memory?
Yeah. What's your favorite Max Bloom memory?
You know, I've been coming here a lot. I've had some really hot fire sets here. I don't know. I mean, him coming to my wallet for sure is kind of overshadowing everything right now.
Hey, at least you have something to remember him by.
I knew Jay. I have a lot of things to remember that motherfucker by. One time I went to a strip club with him. I went to a strip club. He was blackout drunk. All right, he was yelling at the strippers. He was yelling at me. All right, he went to the stage. He stole money. He came back to me, put the money in my face, and he just started yelling, I want to come. So he yelled that like 8 times. He wouldn't stop touching me. I was at a strip club with another man, and he wouldn't stop touching me. Ruined the experience.
I really miss Jetty. Like, Jetty's one of the best people I know. I remember one of our first Facebook conversations.
Tron had a good time.
I remember you guys.
Was about how, like, was not to talk to Kyle. Seriously. Which is, for some reason, I like Kyle. But like,
bye, Kyle.
I'll be back. I'm still have to do my set.
Okay.
Because Kyle told me about that story, about how he stole. Hey, Luis, did Kyle talk to you last night? I'm like, yeah. What did he say to you? And I said, he talked about a time he hanged out with you at a strip club. And he was like, listen, man, he's fucking weird. Me and him have had problems in the past, and he's very toxic. Do not listen to him or try to talk with him. It is the best advice I can give you. No one likes him, right? Yeah. And I was like, trust me. I told him I don't trust him, right? And he was like, he's poison. Anytime he comes around, I will usually leave the conversation. I was like, yeah, he said you stole.
stole tips from strippers? He's like, yeah, I don't really care about that. That's kind of true. You know, I was like...
Your first time doing stand-up was here at Max Blooms.
Yeah.
Can you describe that?
I remember I was just like, this is a day where happiness begins, right? And I was like, I'm gonna record this fucking set, post it on YouTube, because it's gonna be great. But then also, I really had, I had an optimistic and pessimistic view on like what's gonna happen. Because it was either like, I'm gonna do really good, right? Or I'm gonna do really bad and keep on going. And I remember before doing my set, the whole week before, because I tried to do it for like a month. I was trying to like figure out when is Blooms gonna be open, right? And I remember just looking up like how to deal with bombing. Because I knew I was either gonna eat shit or do like good. And I actually did pretty good, like for my first time, I think. Yeah, then after that, I gained a lot of weight and look at me now. Dude, I used
you've
to
become so
skinny.
Sick.
I used to be 170, now I'm fucking 200. Dude, it's a, I call it the Kenny algorithm.
Why is it called the Kenny algorithm?
He looked skinny too. And then once he started doing comedy, he like can't even like wear shirts.
This is true. Kenny used to be really skinny before he started comedy. Before the mic started, Luis showed me old pictures of him on Facebook.
And no joke, this isn't like, oh, all black people look the same.
Now, he had more to say, but I'm cutting him off here because it's funnier that way. I will be brutally honest with you guys. Max Blooms was a terrible mic. Nobody killed, everybody bombed. But it was a collective bomb. You were never alone when you were at Max Blooms. There's another reason why Max Blooms is so important. Take it away, Matt Cole.
This place has got a decade behind us. Some of the better comics who have come out of our scene, guys you've seen on Comedy Central, people you see doing comedy everywhere, started right here at Max Blooms.
For those who practice comedy, it's like living in a pressure cooker. The first 10 years, if you make it to 10 years, there's no money in it. You stay out late, you lose sleep, you explore the deepest, darkest recesses of your mind for material, and the only thing you get from it, especially when you first start out, are people's silence and ambivalence. That would be the scene out of Max Blooms week after week. You would think people would come to hate this, but no, we didn't. That was just Blooms. For a moment in time, Max Blooms was the place where the saddest of clowns came to celebrate their losses and dream about their wins. It was this and so much more for a moment in time.
This is a great mic. Will be one of the best mics ever.
See, this place was known for not being that great of a mic.
It's even still a great mic.
It still was, yeah. You have your good nights, you have your off nights, but overall, what made this mic important was everybody came here.
Yeah.
Everybody came here, everybody hung out, everybody talked. This place was very community-based. You know?
Yeah, and a lot of mics have like a lot of bad owners, but like Kevin's really dope.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He let us go up here and talk about our dicks for like 5 years.
He let a lot of people, like for a long time, talk about their dicks, not just us.
If it weren't for this place, I wouldn't have met you.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have met anybody.
I would have, I don't know how it would have started, because this was like, I looked up and this was the closest place and this was the only place I knew. And then once I started, I was like, yo, Jetty, how do I hit more places? Is there more places like this? He told me about the Facebook group, and I was like, damn it, I have to make a new Facebook. And, like, I have to be old. Oh, this is it?
Yeah. But hey, dude.
We see out.
Usually, there's other places here. The scene will continue. It will thrive. What I tell you earlier tonight. What?
Yeah, you told me something, but, like, this place is great.
Okay. And
it's really great.
Gonna be a rumble on a promenade, and the gambling commissioner's hanging on by the skin of his teeth. Everything dies, baby, that's a fact. But maybe everything that dies, someday he comes back. Put your makeup on, fix your hair up pretty, and meet me tonight in Atlantic City.
Ha 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 ha! city bus.